I had an elderly man that came in. He had been living in a nursing home, and he had been having multiple falls over the past month or so. He had ended up falling that day and hit his head really bad. So the interventionalist, he came in and was ready to take him to surgery, and the son showed up. And the son said, "Hold on just a second. I know my father's wishes. We have this plan in place, and he would not want to do this. He would just want you to make him comfortable. We always think in the ER, we gotta save everybody. We gotta keep everybody going. And sometimes that people just don't want that. Sometimes they just want to be made comfortable." Then I had another situation where there was a mom that was probably in her mid-90s, and she had not really been oriented for a couple years now, and the daughter was making decisions. Well, this mother had also kind of taken a turn for her worst, and when the internalist came in to do the admission workup and assessment, she had asked the daughter if they wanted to do any resuscitation measures. The daughter said for the mom, "I would like her to get compressions." And so I was just thinking, in my own wishes, I don't know if I'd want to be 90 and have compressions, but at the same time, if that's what the next of kin or the person that's overseeing the care, if that's their wish, then that's what we have to follow. Oftentimes when we think of advanced care planning, we think of the elderly and what the elderly would want when they are maybe close to passing. But in the ER, we see all kinds of ages. And with traumas, such as car accidents, it does not discriminate against age. It's so important that before you aren't able to make decisions for yourself, that you are able to at least relay to somebody else that can tell health providers what you wish.